Good afternoon, Commanders. Welcome to this afternoon's live stream where I continue my pilgrimage towards Beagle Point, although I'm taking a slight detour at the moment and exploring a nebula. Anyway, I've come to this planet because it has some bacteria on it. I want to scan. I've been skimming over the surface for about an hour and I've just found some bacteria. So let's go ahead and examine it. Let's get my survey out to scan it. Probably bacterium ACs. Of my ship. So around here. Oh, it's Tiller. This. Let's go sort of this.
Warning. Extremely low temperature detected.
Right, let's see if we can find two more. See if we find some more in this area. person. One more.
Loading gear retracted.
Hopefully I haven't been around in a circle or anything like stupid like that. Right, we are done here. Time to go to our next system. And I'll trip through the number. Maybe not. I'm not even sure I've entered it yet. This will be a fringes. Find some space lights and some clouds. What's going through that room? Say hello. Nice. There we go. She's out of there. 23 weeks going away. I don't know how long I'm going to be streaming for. I'll probably stream until my partner wants me to sleep. Try this one. Small scan. Nothing. Let's see if there's anything so far. No, I don't think there will be. A little too cold. No. Nothing of interest. The less said about that system, the better. Thank you. Oh, I guess there's not much in the system. Something up here. Probably this one. Right, let's go and find these germs. Let's listen to the news.
And killed on Mars. Fleischer was attending a Federal Commerce Authority seminar at the Olympus Village Conference Center. He was targeted in the audience by long-range plasma fire that proved immediately fatal. Security forces were unable to locate the shooter, but the weapon and other items were recovered. Philip Urbano Lyons, the COO of Kane Massey, told the media, "I am saddened and sickened by this tragedy, as is everyone in the Kane Massey family. Johan was approved as our new CEO late last year. He was a much respected champion of enterprise and a close personal friend. No effort must be spared in finding his murderer." Executive Agent Viola Trask provided a statement from the Federal Intelligence Agency. "At present, the assassin's identity and whereabouts remain unknown. The weapon used in the attack was a professionally modified Manticore Executioner marksman rifle. Local police also found advanced ECM equipment that was used to disrupt security systems. These particular models are known to be utilized by undercover Imperial agents. What? However, a thorough investigation is underway and we have drawn no conclusions as yet. Sajine, I believe Salvation survived. Aegis has published a personal statement from Sajine, who claims to have evidence that Salvation planned to escape death in the HIP 22460 system. First of all, yes, Caleb Witchley died when the Thargoids attacked the Bright Sentinel in HIP 22460. But, I believe, only physically. He was developing technology to automatically relocate his mind, an emergency protocol he named the Nemesis Failsafe. I know how implausible that sounds, but the files I recovered from an Azimuth Biotech archive prove his intentions. For several years, Salvation ran a private project to reverse engineer a Guardian artifact which could store consciousness. The design showed neural interactions as digital impulses and made reference to exactly retaining his identity and memories. Salvation had already extended his life to over 250 years and was obsessed with staying alive until he could wipe out the Thargoids. I'm convinced that he has survived in some bodiless form, and that Azimuth has known all along. Aiden Tanner, who works for Aegis as an independent specialist, also released a statement. I'll admit that the designs have found seem authentic and incredibly advanced. But the files contained no concrete proof that the Nemesis failsafe was constructed, or if it could actually work. I'm more concerned that she was being hunted by unknown parties, who would likely have succeeded if not for the Thargod cult's intervention. Perhaps it needs to be restated that actively seeking to hinder Aegis, or its valued personnel, is a crime against all three superpowers. In related news, the Testament megaship that rescued Sajin A from unidentified attackers has now left the Leuten star system, following a week of clemency offered by federal authorities. A spokesperson for President Hudson reiterated that the Order of the Thargod remains illegal in the Federation. Thargoid War Update. March 3309. Vox Galactica correspondent Jade Sandelin reports on the latest developments regarding the war against the Thargoids. In the broad sense, there have been few significant changes in Thargoid tactics. The eight maelstroms continue to send waves of Thargoid vessels deeper into the core systems. Anti-Xeno forces are certainly winning victories, and in some cases retaking previously occupied systems. But we are still losing more than we save. Despite being reformed only recently, Aegis has hit the ground running. Its caustic sink launcher is now available following a successful trial by Aiden Tanner. This ingenious device increases the amount of time that a ship can spend inside a maelstrom before being impaired by corrosive damage. The repulsive energy wave at the cloud centers, however, remains impenetrable. I understand that Aegis has prioritized gathering data about this defense mechanism, and research is underway into possible countermeasures. An until more can be learned about the true nature of the maelstroms, the chances of destroying them are virtually zero. The Alliance, Empire, and Federation are all working to reinforce their military strength. But the front line of this war is primarily being waged by independent pilots and squadrons. Heroic individuals such as Commander Ogmio's TTT, Commander Knight Furry, and Commander Frank XJR have achieved fame for their phenomenal success at destroying Thargoid vessels. Such small rays of hope in the darkness remain few and far between. Many battles are being won, but the creeping fear of inevitable defeat weighs heavily on all our souls. This is Jane Sandilin for Vox Galactica. Stay safe out there. Winters announces election manifesto. The Liberal Party has published a detailed political manifesto in advance of the Federation's presidential election in June. Shadow President Felicia Winters summarized her party's plans during a campaign rally on Rhea 3. The freedoms and privileges of federal citizens have been abused or ignored by the Hudson administration. Our vision for governance focuses on restoring the Federation's core values, offering every individual the opportunities they deserve. As your democratically elected president, I will take great pleasure in dismantling the Proactive Detection Bureau on day one. The mass monitoring of private communications is a violation of civil rights that must end immediately. For those concerned about security, especially the Thargoid threat, I assure you that there will be no reduction in military spending. In fact, our aim is to extend naval and humanitarian assistance to independent systems near our borders that face Thargoid aggression. By supporting systems around federal space, we will establish a robust front line to repel Thargoid forces. The Federal Free Press praised the manifesto, remarking that it displayed the balance of strength and compassion that has long been lacking from our leadership. However, an editorial in Seoul Today claimed, Winters' grip on political reality has been weakened by years of ineffectual hand-wringing. In related news, the Republican Party is currently holding a series of caucuses to select their presidential candidate. Grand Attorney Edwin Espinosa and Congressman Tandeka Kwabe have been eliminated from the running, leaving Vice President Jerome Archer and Secretary of State Lana Berkovich as the remaining nominees. Far God cultists rescue Seo Jin A. Seo Jin A has arrived safely in the Leuton star system, aboard an order of the Far God megaship. A message was transmitted by the first apostle of the True Chapters, a proactive sect of the pacifistic religion, from aboard the Testament. The one known to non-believers as Subject D2 or Seo Jin A is sacred to us as the preceptor, the first human to interpret the will of the Far God. We know her to be a holy emissary, on a personal pilgrimage that exposed her to great danger. I was able to convince my brethren to locate the preceptor and offer her safe harbor from the heretics. I beseeched the preceptor to help us hear the Far God's divine thoughts as she does, but she informed me that the time was not yet right. She requested a reunion with her friends, who also seek ways to commune with its heralds. While this insistence on collaborating with the unworthy is curious, we have faith that the Far God guides her path. One day the Preceptor will prepare us for the extinction of all life. It is our honor to serve her. Professor Albert Tesru gave a statement to the media. I am very grateful to the First Apostle for her help. The Testament's timely intervention routed several unidentified hostile ships that were hunting Seo Jin A. Once she has completed a medical assessment, we hope to learn more about her recent findings. Congressman Tom Gillespie has instructed Aegis not to make formal contact with Far God cultists, whose faith is outlawed in the Federation as well as the Empire. A week's clemency has been issued in recognition of Sir's safe return, but the Testament's presence deep in federal territory is likely to irritate President Hudson. Congress votes against Hudson contravention. President Zachary Hudson's motion to allow him to serve a second...
Well, more than halfway now. I hope it doesn't take too long to find the bacterium. Bacterium can be a pain to find, assuming it is bacterium. In which case, it would be bacterium AC's what? Of course, it might be funticular, but it's unlikely. like a... I fancy going to this bit here. This is going to be a Pectium 80s white. You have to turn around. Scourged. No, actually, I think it was right the first time. Looks a bit bumpy, actually. And some nice flats. Yeah, over here. I just hope it doesn't take too long to find the bacteria. You said that it could be a pain to find. You know, that might be lucky. Some over here. Was that a shadow of a rock? That's a shadow of a rock. Oh, that wasn't too long. Let's look what's up for this while I'm stepping out of the ship.
Warning, dangerously low temperature detected.
Right, we're done here. Go around the planet. The atmosphere. Oh, no atmosphere. That's interesting. That's a Let's go this way. What do one of these? So, 2B. I reckon this is metal rich, so I'll do this one first. Back to 2B. I thought it was metal rich. They're worth mapping if you happen to be close by. About twice the value of a high metal content mold. Let's go this way. Yes, take another picture. Yes, that's a better picture. Right. Let's go for a drive. I'm going for a drive because I might be able to take the bark mounds using the radar. I'll say goodbye to the ship.
Come on.
question. Is there anything interesting? Arsenic. Boron. There is no TC. Yeah. So it's all on off the container. Oh, and it's a corner. Let's see. Let's see. I forget now. It's not right, being a chemist. Of Zero. So there's only four elements left, I need boron, arsenic, titanium, and zirconium. Of course, there's none here. We could be near these, actually. No. I think you get boron only from asteroids. Never mind. No worries. So, no, I don't need to shoot anything. There's nothing to shoot. subconscious in that. These bark bands have been quite elusive. the stream now. Sarah's talking to the stream. So thank you very much for watching. I'm probably streaming in the early hours of tomorrow morning. Till then, thank you very much for watching. It's Commander Clan Wolf Anthrop out.